Dear friends, I'm very thankful for all of you who are still sitting here. It's 4:52. I hope I will finish in 8 minutes. My topic is Choose the Pill. Thank you, Dr. Lalit Shah sir. He has woken up everybody talking about consent. So, is it running? Yes. So, the topic is choosing the pill. What do I mean by choosing the pill? There are so many contraceptive tablets or combined pills available. So which one are you going to use and when? The dose of estrogen has been gradually reduced to 30 microgram or less, and it was thought that we could also reduce the dose of progesterone. Didn't happen. They tried to change the type of progesterone. How does a pill act? It's four ways. In a dose-dependent manner, produces a thick mucosal plug, reduces tubal motility and serial action, makes the endometrium unsuitable for nidation and does not allow ovulation. So it acts in four ways. Estrogen potentiates the action of progesterone. Now in progestrogens we have three types, C21 progestrogen, C19 and spironolactone. C21 is pregnans, C19 esterase and borates, and spironolactone drospirenone. If you just remember this one chart, then I don't have to give more of my lecture. Cyproterone acetate has only anti-androgenic properties. Gestodine has progestational and anti-mineralocorticoid properties. Dinogest has anti-androgenic properties. And drospirenone has progestogenic, anti-androgenic and anti-mineralocorticoid activities. So these are the newer progestins. An active third generation progesterone from gonade family. They are more biologically potent. Dosage required is lower. Dosage to transform the endometrium is lower, and it has a greater suppressive effect on hypothalamic pituitary axis. It is as effective as any other progesterone. Cycle control is good. So, what it's trying to say by so many slides is that it is as effective as the older pills with less side effects. What is the safety profile? Breast tension, headache, nausea, nervousness, vertigo, acne, these are the side effects. And when you start with the newer pills, these side effects over 3 to 6 cycles gradually go down. There are fewer incidences of side effects during the total treatment cycles. When switched from other OCs to gestodine, significant improvement in pre-existing adverse effects. There is no negative effect on lipid metabolism. Body weight remains steady. Your patients ask you, vajan to nahi badhega, goli se mote ho jayenge. These days I am getting a lot of educated patients who use contraceptive pill like an emergency pill. Jab contact hua tab ek goli khali. And when this goes on for 2-3 months, then they come up with irregular bleeding. So this counseling has to be proper. It is not the effect of the pill. It is the effect of taking the pill in a wrong manner. So what do you do? Women who have no complication, according to the side effect, you can shift the pill. If there is unscheduled bleeding, then check for compliance, check drug interaction, do an STD screen and cervical examination at 6 months. The pill can be then gestodine with 30 microgram of ethinyl estradiol. If there is headache during the pill week, then give an extended, during the pill free week, then give an extended cycle routine, and during the pill structure, we reduce the estrogen content. Breast tenderness is there, reduce the estrogen. If there is nausea, take with food or with and take at night, or that doesn't work, then you can reduce the estrogen. New generation pills, gestodine is the preferred progesterone. Even if the woman has uncomplicated diabetes, is a smoker less than 35 or a woman more than 40. Drospirenone is a spironolactone derivative and has properties that go beyond contraception. It has anti-mineralocorticoid properties. So the women who complain of distension abdomen, water retention, and also our PCO patients, they will all do well with this. Because this slide, as I told you before, it has progestogenic, anti-androgenic, and anti-mineralocorticoid activity. There is less of sebum production, and therefore there is less of acne. Anti-androgenic activity is midway between cyproterone dinogest and chlormethylone. Effect on body weight, effect on acne. Body weight, there is no change. Acne decreases. Intermenstrual bleeding decreases significantly over the cycles in new users and those who have what changing their pill. There is significant improvement in all the symptoms of premenstrual syndrome after treatment with drospirenone containing pills. So you can switch easily to a fourth generation pill, and the side effects that are there, they can be mood change, they can be weight gain or bloating, loss of libido and acne. With other pills, if you change the progesterone component, which is preferably drospirenone, all these will decrease. So this is back to the same slide. The take home message is levonorgestrel, which is a second generation, is used mostly for menorrhagia, irregular periods and vaginal bleeding. The pros are it is a gold standard pill, considered safe, as risk of venous thrombosis is very low. The cons are that there is weight gain and some acne. Levonorgestrel, irregular periods, menorrhagia and amenorrhea. It can be used for all three. It has highly progestogenic and specific action, but it has a weak anti-estrogenic activity. Gestodine has good cycle control and is indicated for irregular periods. No negative effects on lipid and carbohydrate metabolism, good cycle control, improvement in existing adverse effects due to pills. Again, it has weak anti-estrogenic activity. And drospirenone is useful in menorrhagia, irregular periods and PCOD. It has an anti-mineralocorticoid action, so there is no weight gain, anti-androgenic, so no acne, and good cycle control compared to others. Thank you.